Once you have your Microsoft Azure account up and running and you're ready to start creating resources on Azure, you're going to need to have a valid subscription. So here in this lesson, I'm going to walk you through what a subscription is. We will define an Azure resource and resource group. Let's check it out. So what is an Azure subscription? An Azure subscription provides you with authenticated and authorized access to Azure accounts. It's a logical entity that allows you to add resources to your Azure tenant. It is the billing boundary, and this is how Microsoft bills you for consuming Azure services. It is also the access control boundary for your resources. This is because it allows administrators to access the resources that you have within that subscription and to delegate access to those resources if necessary. Next, what is an Azure resource? An Azure resource is an entity managed by Azure. Azure resource can be components such as a storage account, a virtual machine, network security group, and so on. Next, what is a resource group? A resource group is a container used to manage and aggregate resources so that they can be managed as a single entity. Now, each resource in Azure must belong to a resource group. That is, when you create a resource in Azure, you will have to put that resource inside the resource group. There are other facts that you need to note about resource groups. One of them is that a resource can exist in only one resource group at a time. And you have the flexibility of moving resources between resource groups. So if I have a resource group A and resource group B, I can move the resources that I have in my resource group A to resource group B. But it's not possible to have one resource be in two resource groups at the same time. Now, quickly, let me show you how you create a resource group from the Azure portal. So to do this, you will need to log into the Azure portal via the portal URL, which is portal.azure.com. Type in your credentials, and it should bring you to the Azure portal's landing page, just as you're seeing here on the screen. So if I need to create a resource group, I can do that by clicking on my left panel here, and I'll click on resource groups. From here, I can click on create. Now, as you can see here, if you want to create any resource in Azure, you will need to have a valid subscription. So everything begins with having a valid subscription in Azure. So I'm going to select my subscription here, and then give my resource group a name. How about we call this AZ900? And then you will need to select a region for your resource group. Keep in mind that you also need to select a region for other resources that you create in Azure, but you don't have to choose the same region for every resource that you create in the same resource group. So you are free to choose different regions for your resources, even though you have those different resources in the same resource group. So I'm going to click on review and create. So I can tag my resource group if I want, but this is a topic that we're going to get to at a later time. So I'm just going to click on review and create. And we have a resource group created. And to view the resource group, you can view it from here, or you can come back to the left pane, click on resource group one more time, and you can look for the resource group that you have just created. And in this case, this is the resource group that we have created, AZ900.